Good evening. Makakilo residents are on edge tonight as flames from a massive brush fire move closer to their homes.
And we are told, as we said a moment ago, the flames at one point coming very dangerously close to some of those homes, causing residents to be asked to evacuate. We have a live report coming from the scene in a moment. First, this is a live look at the fire from the city and county traffic camera looking toward Makakilo. The flames and the smoke also getting close to the H1 freeway. And as a result of that, the far right westbound lane has been shut down.
And that's backing up traffic for miles. We'll check in with TC in just a bit for more on the traffic impact. But first, here's Manolo Morales with the breaking details. Manolo.
Marissa and Dacius, residents have been told to evacuate their homes. That one lane on the freeway has also been shut down because of the fast-moving flames. Now, flames have moved up on a hill along the H1 freeway westbound near the Makakilo off-ramp. Honolulu fire officials tell me that there are 18 companies now battling the fire. Strong winds have made it more difficult to fight the fire as the flames move faster, and they're moving toward a subdivision, putting homes and residents in jeopardy.
We would like everyone in the vicinity to listen to whatever instructions are given to them by the on-scene officials.
Okay.
We want everyone to stay away from the area and keep the roads clear, make way for any emergency vehicles traveling in that direction.
So I had actually went inside the house and then came back and got my neighbor's dog because the dog is outside in the backyard, and got my dog and got my kids. And I said, well, let's go down to the park to go ahead and, you know, wait it out, the new park that they built in our development.
Honolulu police have also notified parents to pick up their children at Makakilo Preschool, which is nearby. Now, Captain Jenkins reminds us that we are getting close to that summer season, which is brush fire season, so residents are asked to keep a fire break area near their property and always have an escape plan. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.
Manolo, thank you. We'll check in with Nestor Garcia in a moment, but as we mentioned, traffic moving at a slow pace because of that brush fire.
Turn things over to TC for that part of our coverage. TC.
All right, so with that brush fire in Makakilo causing HFD to block
Mahalo,
that
one, brother.
You guys mentioned on the H1 Everbound just prior to the off-ramp, really an interesting scene as this developed around 3:30 this afternoon. Traffic, you know, it's slow going just as you approach the fire, mainly in the Makakilo area, the slowdown for you. And then also with that Red Cross setting up the shelter at Makakilo Elementary for evacuees, you can expect some slow traffic in that area. But these are the closest traffic cameras we have to the brush fire at the moment. And then if you're even trying to get out to the west side, it is going to be backed up. Even though University of Hawaii on their summer break were backed up on the viaduct as you approach the Eva N and Wanaloa Freeway in the Fort Shafter Flats, but no stalls or accidents. I'm TC with 92.3 KSSK from the Hawaiian Host Chocolate Traffic Center. Howard, Marissa, back to you.
Thank you, TC, and continuing our team coverage, Nestor Garcia standing by live in Makakilo with more. Nestor.
Hey, Marissa, this is where the fire started. I'm standing here on the H1 freeway going westbound, heading toward exit 2 to Makakilo. And as you can see behind me, this is where the fire actually started. And I was told by police that the wind, together with the tall grass and the kiawe brush, combined together to make this fire move up quickly up the mountainside here towards the Kahivelo subdivision. And I can confirm for you what you just heard, that the Red Cross is preparing to set up a Red Cross shelter. It could be at the Makakilo Elementary School. We'll confirm that for you later. And as I was standing here, I saw yet another unit added to the 18 that already set here to fight this fire. That unit came all the way from Aikahi. So this is a very big fire that you've called units from as far away as the windward side in Aikahi. We're going to be standing by here. We'll be giving you another update at 6 o'clock. And, of course, you can go to our website at K2N2.com to get the latest. This is Nestor Garcia reporting live from the foot of Makakilo.
All right, thank you, Ness. Unfortunately, firefighters and residents, Mother Nature not helping extinguish this large brush fire. Take a look at the quad radar right now to see where the rain is, and there's no rain in the air, not even upstream of Kapolei or Makakilo, where the fire is located. So it hasn't rained all day. In fact, it's even dry on the Ko'olau side. So overall, dry for Oahu, with the exception of a few isolated showers, but none really near where we need it to help those firefighters. And as far as those winds, we've clocked those winds in the Makakilo area and Kapolei at around 8 miles per hour. It was up to 12 just a few minutes ago, and gusts up to 20 miles per hour. And since the fire is in Makakilo near the mountains, the winds are probably stronger. So no help from Mother Nature with the rain or the winds right now. These conditions expected to continue into tonight. Howard, Marissa, back to you.
Thank you, Justin. And we first told you about the brush fire through a push alert. If you want to be the first to know about breaking news while you're on the go, download the free KHON2 mobile app. Make sure you allow push alerts.